Hi-Fi Rush is not your typical game. It's a unique blend of rhythm action and third-person combat where everything, from attacks to environmental movement, syncs to the beat of the music. You guys voted for this review, so even though it's been out for over a year now, I'm giving it my honest review. I've been hurt with other rhythm games before, so I wanted to see if this game could breathe new life into the genre. Developed by Tango Gameworks, the same team behind The Evil Within and Ghostwire Tokyo, Hi-Fi Rush throws you into a vibrant comic book world where you battle a sinister mega corporation with your DIY guitar and probably one of the best soundtracks I've ever heard. So will this be your next game, or will you simply hit skip and search for something else in your playlist? Well, that's what this video is all about. So grab your headphones and get ready. Hi, I'm Marco from Easily Distracted Games, helping you find new or old games for you to get lost in. So let's get started with today's new video. Hi-Fi Rush blends the intensity of third-person combat with the rhythmic precision of music games. Growing up, I used to play hours of Audio Surf 1 and 2, Parappa the Rapper, and eventually the multitude of Guitar Heroes and their subsequent spin-offs. However, it's rare to find the combination of rhythm and combat. I mean, think of what if, say, the Devil May Cry series had to have a rhythm game spin-off. It'd be amazing. So you play as Chai, an aspiring Scott Pilgrim-like rockstar who arrives at the Vandalay Technologies campus to volunteer for Project Armstrong, a test program for cybernetic limb replacement. Things go a bit wrong, and an iPod-like music player falls down on him and gets combined into him, and now he can suddenly feel the environment like everyone's favorite mushroom trip. As a result of the accident caused by the big boss's carelessness, Chai is labeled a defect, and the facility's robotic security forces set out to destroy him. The story sees you team up with various allies to take down this evil corporation, one department at a time. Now, not only can Chai feel the music, the entire world around him pulses to the beat. I'm not even joking here, just look at everything around you. Every little detail is going along with the beat. From the enemies to these hydraulic piston things on the walls, even the air vents themselves. This then filters into the core gameplay mechanic. Everything from attacks to dodges, opening doors to platforming across the stage, syncs seamlessly with the music. Your combat now turns into the spectacle, like some kind of crazy cool choreographed dance, except backed by this kick-ass soundtrack. I won't spoil this too much for you, but the game opens with Lonely Boy by the Black Keys, and from then on I was like, this game is gonna be good. The game does tote a few well-known songs, but the majority of the game is carried by their homebrewed floor-tapping beats that really help bring the world together. And if these videos are helping you, perhaps consider leaving a like or comment, or even subscribe to help other viewers find great games. So let's talk about the fighting, as it's part of the game that's easily the most enjoyable. You start off slow, with basic taps of light and heavy attacks, and then more get added on later in the game. I mean, the first level is basically just a tutorial, drilling in the importance of timing your attacks to the beat. And as someone with less rhythm than an uncooked spaghetti, this did take me a few attempts. But Hi-Fi Rush is very forgiving for people without any rhythm whatsoever. Eventually, some extra characters will come to your side and aid you in your battles, adding to the arsenal of various combos that you can perform, as well as various parries and more to turn battles into this furious flurry of fast-paced action. Most arenas will see you facing off the standard hordes of robots, but soon you'll start encountering mini-bosses that each have their own attack sequences and various weak points. There are a total of 6 bosses in the game that each have a lot of effort in creating their own individual look and feel. To get to these battles, you'll need to traverse through the levels collecting gears to upgrade Chai and his allies. There are also health pickups and energy drinks, all these batteries to increase the gauge to do your special attack. There are also tons of hidden secrets and unlockables in each level, hidden in not so plain sight, which really wants you to just keep exploring each and every level and all the little nooks and crannies. You also have a main hideout where you can just chill after each level. Here you can chat with NPCs, upgrade yourself, or just look at the various unlockables that come with the game, such as various outfits, all this wallpaper that unlocks more images the more challenges you complete. And just look at these levels. So much is going on here, but in a good way. Colors are vibrant and just pop, but they were never too overwhelming for the senses. And that's just what this game is about, fueling all your senses all together, all the time, without it giving you a mild panic attack. Nothing really felt out of place, and even reading the various tablets helped bring in some immersion. I mean, I'm the last person you'll find reading one of these, but I must say I did get some good laughs from them, and just from the whole game in general. The writing of Hi-Fi Rush may not appeal to all. It uses an array of wits, puns, and social commentary that some players might find a little too cringy. I mean, it's one of the reasons why I didn't play this game straight away. However, there was a lot of thought put into the various characters, the plot lines, and just the overall writing itself. And it wasn't a lot, but it's good to see this effort was made here, and it gave me an overall positive experience.
Mr. Chai, what's it? That's Mr. Chai to you.
That's what I just called you.
Okay then!
Judging by the cel-shaded comic book looks of the game, Hi-Fi Rush won't be destroying any PCs anytime soon. It ran perfectly fine on my laptop, but it does come with a large variety of graphical settings to help you out, including many accessibility options. These are perfect for people with no rhythm at all and just want to enjoy the game for what it is. And yes, another cel-shaded game, but you know, it actually works here. Everything in this game gives me a feeling like you're in a comic book, so what better way to portray this than with these graphics? So many good moments were heightened just from the visuals alone. Much like Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, it just helped encapsulate the fun feeling of the game. Then come the sounds. Come on. When you're playing through a game and even just jumping on the platforms gives off this beat that makes you feel like you're creating your own melody, that's definitely a plus in my books. Voice acting is also top notch here and is something I always appreciate in a game. And of course, that soundtrack. While it's not all licensed songs throughout the game, their own in-house songs still got me very hyped even just through the basic platforming. Song selection is amazing too, and I feel like they hired the same people who worked on the FIFA soundtracks. Hi-Fi Rush was released in January 2023 for PC and Xbox, and it somehow then went under the radar and was met with a surprise launch with intense positive critical reception. I remember seeing all these stellar reviews and was dying to play it, but wanted the dust to settle to see if it still holds up. It was then released for the PlayStation 5 in March 2024, and it's currently on the Microsoft Game Pass, which is the current version you're seeing, but it's also going for around 30 bucks on Steam. It'll give you around 11 hours to complete the whole story, but it has a meaty post-game with around 61 hours, so say if you're a completionist and you just want to unlock everything. I have to say that the core mechanic, that everything going to the beat, is fantastic. Attacks, dodges, and even traversal seamlessly flow with the music, making combats and movement feel like a choreographed. It's easy to pick up, but mastering the rhythm adds a bit of depth to the game. And the entire experience just felt curated and wonderful. The game is also not too harsh if you mess up or say get injured, so my tone deafness was very forgiven most of the game. Something I also really enjoyed was the writing. The characters are full of charm, from the aspiring rockstar protagonist Chai to his quirky allies. Each bring a unique personality and combat style to the table, and there's tons of humor thrown into the mix. I cracked up in multiple cutscenes, reading the various notes along the way, and even just what was happening during a battle. Again, this might not be everyone's cup of tea, but damn, I haven't laughed this much at a game in ages. If you've ever worked in a large corporation that's filled with various departments, then you'll definitely get a few laughs at how the game pokes fun at them. Now, usually games with so much color can be a put-off, but damn, I just love them here. I always caught myself oohing and aahing quite often, especially with the battles. Don't forget this game comes with a photo mode too, which I think every game just needs to have. Full stop. Hi-Fi Rush's eye-catching visuals pop with color, and the animation is incredibly smooth, bringing each punch, kick, and guitar riff to life. And yes, the biggest pro here is that killer soundtrack. The music is the heart and soul of Hi-Fi Rush. Each track perfectly complements the action, keeping you pumped throughout your adventure. As you might know, me not switching to Spotify is a huge deal. And I'll actually drop the game's playlist in the description here because it's that good. but I'd recommend not listening to it quite just yet, as it'll definitely spoil the later levels for you. Now, as much as I enjoyed the battles in this game, I really didn't enjoy the platforming sections all too much. At first I was like, yeah, that's pretty cool, ooh, some side-scrolling, that's pretty fun. But halfway through the game, the corridors, I don't know, just got a bit boring. I kept saying to myself, just get me back to the action, I just want to fight. You're constantly doing things along the way though, but I felt like they could have shortened some of these sections. Then looking at the actual fighting of the game, yes, it doesn't punish you for repeating moves, but maybe it should, I don't know. After you defeat the first boss, your combos start to look and feel somewhat familiar, even with the inclusion of your various buddies. I mean, the part where they included the parry, I was not really a fan. So much was going on, I just found I could just smash my way out of it. Then tacking on extra moves just felt a bit cumbersome. I still really enjoyed the combat, but I felt like, yeah, I could just win most encounters just by button mashing over and over. Overall though, Hi-Fi Rush is a breath of fresh air in the rhythm and action genre. It's a stylish and innovative game that injects infectious music, engaging combat, and stunning visuals into a fun and unforgettable experience, even with today's standards. While the platforming sections and some repetitive battles might not win awards, the overall package is a must play for anyone looking for a game that'll get them tapping their feet or snapping their fingers. If you're mediocre with rhythm, it's still a good game. If you have good to great rhythm, this game is fantastic. For me, I love rhythm games in general, and Hi-Fi Rush is easily the best to come out since probably Crypt of the Necrodancer, and if you don't know what that is, I highly recommend checking it out. Hi-Fi Rush reminds me of the old PS2 era where games were quirky, fun, and lighthearted, and didn't take themselves too seriously. And if you want something to bring back that nostalgia, then I highly recommend trying out this game. If you've enjoyed this review, don't forget to share your thoughts in the comment section below. But other than that, this is Marco here from Easily Distracted Games, and most of all, don't stop gaming.
Don't worry, I got this.
Lift is running a bit late.
I'm sure they'll be here.
Huh.